Newcastle going above Manchester United.
I was waiting for that.
In the table. And Rio, I blame you because you dropped the Rolls-Royce line before the match when bigging up Mickey van der Ven.
Well, sometimes Rolls-Royces do have technical issues and they have to go for an MOT and get a once-over, but...
Okay. I guess you got the joke. So before the game, Rio Ferdinand actually said that Mickey van der Ven is the Rolls Royce of defense and all that. You know, people try to put some labels on players too soon, probably. Saliba is the next coming of such and such, but that's the way it is. That's how the business works. And he had a game to forget, to be honest with you. Horrible, horrible game. And people were reminding Rio what he said before the game. But that's part of the game. So Tottenham Hotspurs, in case you didn't know, they got seriously smashed. They got smashed 4-0 by Newcastle United. They did the double on them this season. So you see all kind of memes here. Look at Van de Ven. Whenever Newcastle player tries to dribble past him, like, he had a nightmare. Isak really, really humiliated this guy. 2 goals in 2 minutes conceded by Liverpool. Or by Tottenham Hotspurs, and part of that was because of Mickey van der Ven. But he's still a young player compared to the age that he's supposed to mature as a defender, as a centre back.
Hey, bigger fish to fry, FC. They call it.
But Isak, that brother is in another level. Wow, what a player, man. What a player Newcastle got. All they have to do now is just to try to keep him fit, because it looks like he has a lot of injury issues that need to be fixed. But he also still young, so it could improve in the next coming month. I think they are working on it. But he's one of the best in Europe right now. What a player, man. What a player. So we're seeing just the quote here from Rio. But it didn't work according to the plan. Okay. Isak. What a player, like I just said. Isak equals Latin. Yeah, they are from the same country, right? Oh, my goodness. Me. Two Swedish strikers who have greatly impressed in the Premier League. Yeah, Zlatan, remember before that ACL injury at Manchester United, he was so, so good. 17 goals. That's something. So 2 more goals added to Alexander Isak tally for the season. 24 appearances, 17 goals. Just imagine if he didn't have a lot of injuries this season. He missed a lot of games. So if he was fit, probably he was going to have more than 20 goals by now in the Premier League. So congratulations to the brother, man. Doing pretty good. In the last 6 home games, he scored all of them. Some of them even a brace, like today. 2 goals. Unstoppable, this guy, man. You got a lot of football because of people like Isak. What a player. And who do you think is gonna buy him? Do you think, you know, Newcastle United are gonna accept to lose him? So April 2023, Newcastle 6, Tottenham Hotspurs 1. April 2024, Newcastle 4, Tottenham Hotspurs 0. Tottenham, when they go to St. James Park, it's always a problem. And you can see in this meme here from BR. Very, very interesting. Boogie team. This is the definition of boogie team. Tottenham conceded as many goals against Newcastle this afternoon as Arsenal have in the in their 11 Premier League games in 2024. They only conceded 4 goals. Oh my goodness. 11 games, 11 goals conceded, but Tottenham conceded the same amount of goals in one game. Mate. Okay. This is just to confirm from Tottenham Hotspur's official account. Defeat in the North East, 4-0.
We got bigger fish to fry. We got bigger fish to fry.
Let's now go and talk about some details from this game. 4-0 to Newcastle United. Alexander Isak, 2 goals. Anthony Gordon, 1 goal. And Fabian Schär, 1 goal. Assist, Gordon, Guimarães, Anthony Gordon again. So he got like 2 assists. Awesome. Let's check on some statistics here. Ball possession. Tottenham Hotspur 73%. And that's why I always tell people that possession means nothing in football. They lost 4-0. And the team that won had only 27% possession. Shot on target. Look at that. Tottenham Hotspur only 2. Newcastle 5 shot on target. They score 4 goals. Efficiency. Shot all together. 18 for Newcastle, 11 for Tottenham Hotspur. Awesome stuff.
It's an absolute disgrace.
And Isak was voted as the man of the match. You know, well deserved. 2 shots on target, 2 goals. What else can you ask from a player? What do you think about Tottenham Hotspur? What position they're going to finish on the table? Looks like they are collapsing at the moment. And they might miss out on the Champions League spot. Before the game, Tottenham Hotspur fans were celebrating already. They said they are going to destroy them. But unfortunately, the game is played on the pitch, not on paper. Timo Werner missed chances as always, or as often. But he's still a Chelsea legend. Won the Champions League with Chelsea and other trophies. Nothing to say about that. But what a game of football that was, man. Reminding you the table here. Manchester City, by the time of recording, they are playing now. So I'm going to make another video later on to talk about the entire day of Saturday. Manchester City, 73 points. Yeah. They are top of the league temporarily. They are playing right now. So 1-0, 20 minutes played already. We don't know what the final score is going to be. Arsenal, 71. Liverpool, 71. Aston Villa, 60. Spurs, 60. Newcastle United, 50. That tells you everything about Spurs, right? They have a lot of credit in the bank that even when they lose games like this, it doesn't really affect their Champions League position. Look at that. Look at the difference. 10 points between them and Newcastle United. Tells you everything, man. They started the season very, very well. And they can afford to lose games and still in a very good position. Chelsea are ninth for now. And the relegation zone, Luton, Burnley, and Sheffield United.